Hello, everyone, and welcome to St. Michael Albertville High School for CTN's coverage of the Section 5 3A Volleyball Tournament. Joey Young, Howie Shapiro up above the action, and Howie, first round action has the number 5 Knights from St. Michael Albertville hosting the number 12 seed Coon Rapids Cardinals.
Yeah, they come in with a 16-11 record, do the Knights and the Cardinals, who have been struggling. We've talked about their toils this whole season long, just 3 wins on the season. It'd be interesting. Cardinals are missing a couple players, brought a couple girls up from JV. We'll talk about more of that later.
There's a look at the brackets. The quarterfinal round on Thursday. Winner of this game will move on to take on number 4 seed Blaine. Chapel Park, the number 1 seed, will host the winner of Buffalo and Orono. Wayzata, the winner of Maple Grove and Rogers. Osseo will get the winner of Delano and Park Center. All those play-in games taking place right now.
Yeah, so this is an opportunity for the Cardinals. You know, I talked to Coach Arcand earlier, and he said they're excited about today. They're looking at this as an opportunity. They certainly have nothing to lose at this point, coming in as the number 12 seed. But bringing up a couple of girls from the JV team, getting the start tonight, they're see if they can kind of mix this lineup in and see if they can get something rolling here against this higher-seeded Knight team.
There's a look at your starting lineups. On the left, the Cardinals, Botch, the setter. Harris Wright, the hitters, Bussey, the setter. Or on the right side, Olivia Weiss and Kayla Thoen are the others. Lexi Nelson, Aaliyah Dorland, Michaela Henderson, Macy Gavick, Syria Tanchin, and Katriana Ailtz is the starting lineup for St. Michael Albertville.
Head coach Jill Anderson, her second season for St. Michael Albertville Knights, talked to me about, they're just trying to get into a rhythm here. She's got very nice talent on this roster, especially some of the younger players, which we'll see tonight. A freshman and a sophomore get the start for the Knights here. So a couple younger players get their opportunity here in this first section contest.
Lexi Nelson will serve it up, and this game is underway. Cardinals wait, passed across by Yang. Big attack in the middle, and finding the corner on the far side was Sierra Tanchin.
Well, Tanchin did a nice job of just finding that line. She's gonna shoot with the kill there. It's just gonna come fall on the inside of that line, giving them first point of the game.
And a little bit of love from the top of the tape. Gets the ace for the Knights.
Well, Tanchin comes into this contest with 191 kills on the season, the leader in this squad. Been looking to set her quite often here tonight.
Fast across by Thoen. Knights set up, and the attack is good for Aaliyah Dorland. And a quick 3-0 lead for St. Michael Albertville here in the first set.
Yeah, Kayla Bussey not able to handle this one as she puts it right into her.
Coon Rapids first substitution of the match. Alex Wright going to come in.
Well, Coach Arcand's going to try and mix things up here tonight in the lineup.
Little miss on the attack attempt, but Yang able to push it over, and that one on the wrong side of the stick, so that'll be a misplay Cardinal point.
Well, the Cardinals just want to keep this score close if they possibly can. They want to keep it within a few points as this first game moves on.
Laura Botch, the first serve of the evening for Coon Rapids. The attack is long for Tanchin.
Well, they also, too, want to see if they can force the Knights into some unforced errors like you saw there. They'll take the points any way they can get them.
And an ace as that one kind of knuckled in front of Aaliyah Dorland. And we're right back to 3-3. And a miss hit by Tanchin into the net gives Coon Rapids its first lead at 3-4.
Well, a couple of them here by Tanchin. A couple of misplays there, and you're going to see it again. She's trying to time that one, puts it right into the net, and the Cardinals take that 4-3 lead.
Just passed across and to the floor. Gives St. Michael the side out and evens the score at four apiece.
Yeah, smart play there on St. Michael's. Oh, St. Thomas, St. Francis, St. Michael. I'll get it eventually.
Passed over by Wright. The attack is good by Tanchin.
Well, that time Tanchin did not miss that, again, with some authority on that kill. So nice set to her, and she pounds the ball to the floor.
Wright attacking for Coon Rapids. The Knights able to pick it up. And the kill on the near side by Michaela Henderson. Oh, she touched the net. It's going to be a Coon Rapids point, 5-all. Callie Harris at the service line. Set went right back to Henderson. This time she puts it down and stays off the net.
Yeah, I was watching Henderson in warmups, and she's got a nice leverage, nice ability to get high up to that net. And then you saw her put it down with some authority.
Tanchin serve picked up by Thoen. Wright attacking for the Cardinals. Therefore, it is Dorland, and they will go back to Henderson. Just tipped it over the block. And Coon Rapids touches the net.
You're going to see the action here at the net. You're going to watch the Cardinals just get that little bit of net there. It gives the 7-5 lead to the Knights.
Yang had to dive for that, and it went right back to the net. Pushed right back over by Macy Gavick. And a timeout for Coon Rapids early, trailing 5-8.
Well, you know, after STMA opened up a lead a little bit, Coon Rapids did a nice job of getting back into this. Actually took the lead for a little bit of while. So I think Coach Arcand just kind of wants to settle things down with his girls and talk about the fact they're just down by three. We're right in this. Just keep doing what we can do.
Winding down the fall season on Sports Night, we'll have highlights of this and the football quarterfinal on Friday against Totino Grace coming up on next Monday's show.
Actually, I don't think we have a show on Monday.
Tuesday. Yeah. I apologize.
Is it Tuesday?
Tuesday the 1st. Okay. We will not be doing it on Halloween.
No, we will not.
So it's not every Monday. It's most Mondays, but not every Monday. Yeah, just a couple of regular season shows remain,
yeah,
and then it's time to wrap it up and get ready for winter.
Yeah, it's going to be here before we know it.
Tanchin continues to serve. Big block on the far side. That was Kat Ailtz along with Macy Gavick. Keep the roll alive for St. Michael Albertville. Tanchin serve continues.
Well, Gavick leads this squad in blocks.
Try to catch the Knights sleeping and unsuccessful at doing that. Here's a big kill for Gavick.
Well, after a little bit of a hiccup, St. Michael Albertville. I'll get it by the time
St. Phillips, St. Peter,
St. Paul, St. Louise. Oh, man. I'm going to call him STMA. It's easier.
Attack by Wright is blocked again. Big defense on the right side of the net for St. Michael. Albertville has him up 11-5.
Yeah, Gavick again gets a piece of that one. You're going to watch it. Just nice timing at the net and the block back. I guess the Cardinals touching that on that as well. Coach Arcand doesn't agree. 12-5 now, STMA.
Hey, you got it right.
I know. Well, I think it's easier for me.
It's a lot of syllables, St. Michael Albertville. Wright didn't quite get the angle she wanted on that, played into the net. It's an 8-point lead for the Knights.
Yeah, we talk about this sport being a sport of runs, and you're seeing the Knights go on one to extend that lead.
Punched over by Alex Wright. Big attack by Henderson, saved near the back line by Yang. Valiant effort going to the bench by Laura Bouch, trying not to make sure she didn't hit either of her coaches.
Right in between them.
But unable to bring it back into play.
Sorry, coach.
Attack in the middle by Weiss is denied, and Cardinals look like they might be able to return it again, but unfortunately a carry means a 10-point lead now for St. Michael Albertville at 15-5. Emma Wright trying to attack, blocked back. And St. Michael Albertville touches the net, and that's what ends their long streak.
And that was a long one, no question about it. But again, you know, they're doing, the Knights are doing a pretty good job of just, you can see where they touch the net, but a pretty good job of timing their blocks here against Coon Rapids.
Yeah, they reeled off 10 straight points to open up that big lead. And now Coon Rapids, a little bit of a mountain to climb as Amy Slack comes in to serve, and there was power on that one from Henderson.
Yeah, Henderson, again, with some authority to the floor. They quickly get that 10-point lead back. Watch Henderson, just a nice elevation. Good follow through, a nice kill.
Grace Steffens checks in, takes over at the service line for the Knights. Alex Wright attacking in just too long.
Henderson fourth on this team in kills, 101 on the season coming into tonight.
Played over by Thorne. Knights able to catch the Cardinals off guard. And they nearly got it back, but not quite. One too many plays, and it's 18-6.
Now they've just done a nice job with those touch hits tonight, as you mentioned, catching the Cardinals off guard.
Punched over. Knights will attack with Henderson. Slack is there. She'll attack from midcourt, but into the net.
Timeout, Coon Rapids, trailing 19-6. You know, it looked early on like the Cardinals would stay in this first game, but give credit to the Knights. They did a nice job of going on that run, opening up the big lead, and they're continuing to do so, up 19-6. If you're a Cardinal fan, you may not like what you're seeing here in this first game, but you definitely should like us on Facebook if you hadn't had the opportunity. Make sure you go find us, like us, and you'll get to see what's going on in our world, and get to see some good pictures, and go to the Joe Yund exhibit and see all Joe's pictures on there.
14-1 run for St. Michael has them up 19-6 here in the first set. A heavy favorite, of course, the heaviest favorite in these play-in games are the first round of the section tournament is the number 5 hosting the number 12. And they want a piece of Blaine. Bengals await
they
the
do.
Number 4 seed in Thursday's quarterfinal round. Slack was there, but no one to catch the pass. An ace for the Knights.
There's head coach Arcand. Trying to see if he can figure some things out here for his squad tonight.
Played over by Lauren Koss. Set it back up for Michaela Henderson, and she finishes the job again.
So good passing and a nice set here, and Henderson able to pound it to the floor.
Attack in the middle that time by Ailts. Right to the back line for the point, 22-6.
There's head coach Jill Anderson. Second year as the head coach here at St. Michael Albertville. Got it.
Another big block at the line. Cardinals able to recover, but the play too long from Laura Botch. And 23-6 lead for St. Michael, just 2 points away from victory here in the first set. Henderson again.
Well, she's automatic from that point. And again, it's all in the set. Does a nice job of getting the elevation and the push to the floor. You can watch it here, just coming from her position as an outside hitter.
And now set point in the first. Wright punches it over. Here comes Henderson again. She found that far line. And St. Michael Albertville, a 25-6 win in the first set. It was decisive. The Knights wanted to make a statement, and they have. See if the Cardinals can respond in the second. More playoff volleyball coming up next on CTN. Set belonged to the higher seeded Knights after a little bit of a slow start where they allowed Coon Rapids to stay in the game thanks to several misplays. They really got it going. They went on a 14-1 run and they never really looked back, racing to a 25-6 win. I guess they went on a 20-1 run after a 5-5 tie. They won it.
Yeah, they did.
With
they did
a 20-1 run.
With some authority, and they're going to look to come back and do the same thing here to Coon Rapids in set number two.
Zoe Miller, the libero for the Knights, wearing the golden jersey. Cardinals with the first service, and she will receive right into the net, and St. Michael not going to be able to return it. So Coon Rapids able to get the first point of set two.
Yeah, just didn't get under that what she wanted on that return and pushed to the net. Not much the Knights could do.
Attack that time by Dorland. Cardinals respond with Whitfield. Knights continuing to attack, but that one just a little bit long for Tanchin. And Coon Rapids an early 2-0 lead.
Well, and the key for Coon Rapids here in this second contest is to try and hold that lead and see what they can do about building it and going on a run of their own.
Pass across, catches the Cardinals sleeping, gets the side out for St. Michael. Set goes to the far side for Nelson to attack. Cardinals able to pick it up, and a little bit of a miss hit by Callie Harris on the near side attack. It's 2-2.
You know, Cardinals missing Ellie Hintze tonight. She's not here, and that's an important part of their team as the service goes long.
Set in close and huge power from Grace Mauersberger.
Yeah, she
left it for her on a little bit of a back set.
And again, watch this.
The defense all set up in front of the set, and no chance to shift and try and handle that kind of power from Mauersberger. Another long serve will give the side out and the lead back to Coon Rapids.
Again, Coon Rapids just keeping it where they need to keep it here in this second contest, with holding that 1 point lead. But we saw them do that in that first set, and then St. Francis of St. Michael Albertville made them they pay for that. Told you by the third set I should be okay. I should have stuck to STMA.
Evie Harrington the kill in the middle this time, and it's all square at fours here in the second set. Amanda Timp at the service line. Set and a kill for Macy Gavick.
Yeah, a nice job by Gavick on that right side front. Pound that point to the floor. Not much Cardinals can do.
First lead here of the second set for St. Michael. Black played it across, and Knight's not ready. It's 5-all.
Got a little miscommunication on that side.
Nisha Whitfield replaced by Alex Wright as we take another look at the pass from Slack finding the hole in the St. Michael defense. Yang able to pass it back across. Set in the middle, just a fingertip for Harrington. Cardinals scrambling to recover. Emma Wright on the attack. St. Michael able to pick it up, and that is on the wrong side of the post. And a play point for the Cardinals. They're back in front 6-5.
Again, keep this thing close. Exactly what the Coon Rapids Cardinals are doing here in set number two. They just have to avoid what happened to them in that first set when they kept it about the same score.
Well-timed tip by Evie Harrington between the block attempt to the floor and a 6-all score. St. Michael sending Haley Kruger to the service line. Yang attacking long.
Yeah, a little bit too much on that. Just trying to go for that back line. Knights take the lead.
Yang plays it across and just a little too long. That was a tough one to let fall, but wisely done. Along the back line by Haley Kruger. Timeout, Coon Rapids.
I think this is somewhat a similar point where Coon Rapids called their first timeout in set number one.
Very similar. 8-6 versus 5-6.
Yep.
Or 5-8.
See if I can. I was just trying to see if I can hear anything that that Coach Arcand is saying. But again, you know, keeping it close—that's the key here for the Cardinals. If they can do so here in set number two.
And unfortunately, that out of that timeout was that first timeout of
the
first
set
is when the big run.
Yep.
Well, they stopped right at the start of the big run, and then the timeout unfortunately did not stop it.
Nope.
As it is meant to. We'll see if it has the desired effect this time coming out of the timeout. Olivia. Service into the net will at least give Cardinals the side out and an opportunity to try and find a little run of their own. Allison Yang to the service line.
Yeah, just trailing by a point at this point in the game, so that's an opportunity, as you mentioned, to see if they can get things going for them. And that's going to be out. Unfortunately, they can't keep their serve going here.
That's another one that just wasn't long by much.
Nope.
But the Knights court awareness paying off here early in the second set. And serving up the ace is Courtney McCabe. Little tip across, St. Michael able to pick it up. The attack by Gavick is picked up by Alex Wright. The Cardinals with a two-hand touch. Give the point to the Knights anyhow, 7-11. Strong play at the net on both sides, but St. Michael Albertville able to win the touch battle at the net. Aaliyah Dorlin keeping it on the Cardinals' side.
We saw a lot of that in that first set, a lot of touch battles won at the net by the Knights.
Callie Harris, an effective kill, first kill of the match for Coon Rapids.
Yeah, Harris with a nice kill there, as you mentioned, this is the first one of the night. And that's, the Cardinals are going to need to see more of that if they're going to be successful here this evening.
Kayla Thoen to serve. Picked up by Miller. Tipped over by Tanchin. Cardinals able to recover. Big block at the net by Tanchin to get the point.
Now Tanchin again timing that perfectly.
She's definitely a nice volleyball player. 6-footer, that helps. Four 6-footers on the roster for St. Michael. You got me doing it now.
I'm glad I could help.
Attack by Dorlin picked up. Cardinals able to play it over. Tanchin in the middle again, gets another kill. The lead is 6. Service into the net will give the side out and the point to Coon Rapids.
Oh, the Cardinals trailing by 5. Just trying to keep this thing within reason.
Diving save near the back line. And Yang able to pass it over. And a good quick reaction at the net by Callie Harris. Gets her another kill. Cuts the lead to 4.
Yeah, quick position at the net for Coon Rapids. Gets him the point. Harris just with a little push back over.
Mauersberger is denied, but a great save. And then a carry gives the point to the Cardinals. Seen a couple of those now on either side of the net where someone's made a great save, only for the next touch to be illegal. Attack by Dorland picked up. And now a cross by Fosland. Mauersberger had to wait on that, and she played it too long. Timing just off a little bit. And Coon Rapids back within a pair.
Yeah, again, you know, just cut into that lead. That's all you can ask for at this point. Put a little pressure on the Knights side of the court.
Not a lot on that attack from Tanchin. Fosland will pass it back across for the Cardinals. Pushed across. Fosland defends it. Here comes Tanchin. A little tip. Give him a little bit of a change up there to get the point.
Well, you have to be so concerned about her power at the net, and she just does a nice, a smart play by just pushing it back over the net. Timing that perfectly, getting the Cardinals coming down from the block attempt.
And now an ace for Aaliyah Dorland. Makes it 16-12. Great save by Dorland. Tack and a nice save on the other side by Thoen. Mauersberger the kill to get the Knights the point.
Oh, you talked about 4 6-footers in this lineup for the Knights, and you have to be so concerned defensively if you're a Coon Rapids player, which particular player will get that opportunity for the kill. You see it there.
Only 1 6-footer in the Cardinals roster. And just under 6 foot is Nisha Whitfield right there, and she gets the kill. Gets quick side out back for the Cardinals.
Luka with a nice kill there, get the point.
Whitfield is listed at 5'11". Service is long. Give the point and the ball right back to St. Thomas. Zoe Miller at the service line. Alex Wright able to find that back, or that's Emma Wright, excuse me.
And she just
right
finds
at the back line.
Just finds that line.
Amy Slack checks in and takes over serving for the Cardinals. And didn't get what she wanted on it. Set for Wright, she gets a kill cross court. Yeah, and all of a sudden, the Cardinals' offense has awoken a little bit.
Yeah, and just trying to keep the score manageable, as you see, a nice job there, cross court to get the point. 19-15 in favor of the Knights.
Nice defense at the net. That one just fell over. Wright was ready for it. Yang didn't get the angle she wanted. And it's 20-15, St. Michael Albertville. Dig by Slack. Emma Wright is blocked. Cardinals able to pick it up, get it back over. Tack and a kill on the far side for Dorland.
Again, good setup to that far side. Dorland able to push the ball to the floor.
Timeout Coon Rapids, 21-15, the lead for St. Michael.
Again, the Cardinals, you know, again, trying to keep this within reason, but a nice kill there for that 21st point for the Knights here in set number two. Nice diving attempt. Unable to dig it out.
Coon Rapids just trying to slow the roll of the home squad. They need a run of their own coming out of this break, try and keep from falling down 2-0.
Well, and that's what Coach Arcand is hoping for by stopping play here and talking to his girls a little bit. So you're within 6 points at this point. And just continue to improve. And we saw some flares from their offense here in the second set, so they're trying to do the same thing here.
Haley Kruger to serve for the Knights. Slack near the back line. Emma Wright attacking, and she'll get the kill.
Yeah, a good timeout coming out. Get the point, get the serve. Now trailing by 5.
Yund officially.
Of course.
St. Michael had 10 kills to Coon Rapids 0 in the first set. And here in the second, I've got St. Michael with the 7-6 advantage in kills in the second set. Make it 8. Big power down the line by Macy Gavick.
Yeah, and they get that elevation and they get that opportunity to set these taller girls up in front of the net, and they take good opportunity here as she gets the kill to the floor.
Cardinals unable to return it. Now just 2 points from a two-set lead for St. Michael Albertville. Passed across by the Cardinals. Set in the middle, and that's she did out. Not find nope. the corner.
Good thought to find that corner, but just a little bit too much on it. See it there, just trying to go for that corner.
I don't care where it goes. There was room there.
There was room.
It's not able to keep it in play. It's 23-17 as Thoen serves for the Cardinals. Set goes to Tanchin. This time she doesn't try to be so fancy, just right to the middle of the court.
Oh, she sees that big hole
and
on the floor.
Set point.
In the Cardinal defense and able to makes it able to make a count.
Service by Lexi Nelson, throwing there for it. Attacking is Koss again. Tanchin puts it where they ain't and finishes set two with a 25-17 win for her St. Michael Albertville Knights. The Knights are riding high, a 2-set-to-none lead. We will take a break and be back with set three right after this.
So, I just moved in with his family, and it's embarrassing. The little one, he likes to go outside and crawl around in the giant litter box. I don't know what he's doing. I mean, I was born, and I knew how to use the litter box. Look at that. That's disgusting. Oh, poop already. You're making me nervous. Oh, okay, I can't look at this anymore. I really hope he grows out of this, for his sake.
Back at St. Michael Albertville, the Knights a little tougher time in set two, but still able to get the victory over the 12th seeded Cardinals. Coon Rapids got a little more offense going in the second half, or in the second set. They were not able to get any kills in the first, and they were able to find six in the second from four different players. So nice to see them getting some offense going. They need to be able to turn that on a little bit earlier here in set number three. St. Michael Albertville, the first serve, but it's out of bounds.
And there you see the stats in that second set. See the 9-6 kill advantage to STMA.
And I think we're going to see some more of that here in the third.
I agree.
Went away from Tanchin a little bit in that second set. I think trying to open up their offense and do some different things with some different players with that lead already established. But may see them go back to their heavy hitters here in set three, trying to end this one.
Coach Anderson said, you know, our goal is to win it in three.
Anderson spun that one off the block. Gets the kill and a 2-1 lead for St. Michael Albertville.
Yeah, and you know, up 2-0, they can see that they can take advantage
2-1.
Here. Or 2-0 in sets. They can take advantage and see if they can make it an early night for themselves. Early night for the Knights.
Little tip past the defense by Gavick. Three straight points completed by three different 6-foot players. Whitfield hammered that one through the block, but the Knights able to recover. Punched over by Koss. Tanchin to the corner.
Well, yeah, you were correct, Joe. They're going to go to their big hitters up front. They were so successful at that, as you mentioned, got away from it in set two, but so successful in set one.
Tanshin's a nice volleyball player, there's no question. And as is Henderson, especially from that left side. Cardinals not able to handle that one. And quickly a 5-1 lead for St. Michael.
And this is exactly what Coon Rapids did not want to have happen, is the Knights jump out to this to a quick lead, and they have.
Whitfield's attack picked up near the end line. Here comes Henderson back the other way, and she's got another kill.
Yeah, you talked about Henderson a little bit earlier. She's a good volleyball player, very solid at the net.
Just 5'8".
Yeah.
But she's got some ups. She's got some ups and she's got some power. Serve into the net will give the side out to the Cardinals. Tanshin right at the net and got a little too much. Oh, Coon Rapids
got the net.
The net.
Yep.
Well, Tanshin was right on top of it that time, but she just left the auditorium. Oh, she's back. Nice diving save by Miller. Huge attack by Gavick. And that one's out of bounds.
That'll make it 8-2 in favor of the Knights.
And a service ace for Miller. Keeps the roll going and forces the Cardinals to take another early timeout. Trailing 7 early here in the third.
Yeah, and again, Coach Arcand needs that timeout to just try to settle things down here. But you give the Knights credit. They've been able to go on a number of runs that really have done a good job of extending their leads.
And for the Cardinals, Coach Arcand just doing what he can to rally them, keep their spirits up, and let them know that they have to go out there and they have to play one point at a time, try and end the streak, and then see if they can get one of their own. Set for right. And a little mistimed, ended up wide of the post. Emma Wright will get the kill. Side out Coon Rapids.
Oh, she got enough of it where there was a hole in the defense and she found the floor. Cardinals.
She's the taller of the two twins, listed at 5'3 and 5'5. Of course, that may have changed since the beginning of the season.
Very possible.
Those heights, I'm assuming, were measured. Gavick right in the middle, and no answer from the Cardinals.
Oh, Gavick, another one of those players for the Knights, really solid at the net. She's 6'2.
Yeah, I was going to say, she's the tallest on the roster at 6'2. Whitfield attacking for Coon Rapids and gets the ball right back.
Yeah, we've seen that from Whitfield a number of times this year. She's play a solid net play as well. So she's great elevation.
Well, the one really nice thing for the Cardinals is a lot of youth on this program.
Yes.
A lot of their leaders this year have had to learn on the job But we'll be right back next season. Henderson, another kill for St. Michael.
Well, and you look at Henderson, and she's just a ninth grader. So she's got Coach Anderson talked about the youth in this program as well, and certainly she's one of them.
Yeah, Tanchin, just a sophomore.
Yeah.
That's two. Their two biggest hitters are going to be here a lot longer.
Yes.
Aaliyah Dorlin getting the kill this time for St. Michael. Again, it just outside the post, so St. Michael Point. A 10-point lead now for the Knights. And a little knuckleball causes some confusion on the Cardinal side, and it leads to an ace.
Yeah, 15-4 for STMA.
Right blocked on the left side. A 12-point Knights lead. Alex Wright had to kind of fall back for that one, but able to put just what she wanted on it right into the middle of the defense where no one was.
Yeah, able to find that hole in the floor. 16-5.
And with Allison Yang at the line, I feel a streak.
Okay. Hope you're right.
Picked up by Miller. Attacks on the wrong side of the post for Green. And that'll be a Cardinal point. Don't call it a streak yet. It's coming.
Oh, you got to get the first one in order to be a streak.
Correct. That's the second. That's 2 points. Trying to cut the deficit to single digits. And there it is, Fosslin at the net, poking it to the floor. By Breen, diving save by Yang. They'll go back to Breen, and this time she'll get the kill and end that streak early for the Cardinals.
I'll get that lead back to double digits at 10.
Courtney McCabe to serve. Slack on the receive, and the Cardinals. They're going to redo the point,
yep,
because the Cardinals' ball did not go back around the net. The flag went up.
It did.
But it was not whistled, so they're just going to replay the point. Attack in the middle by Koss is good. Coon Rapids will get the point anyhow. I'm sorry, that was Olivia Weiss on the kill.
See it up front there again, and one of the Knight players got a piece of it.
Tipped over by Tanchin. Cardinals able to play it back across. Set to Breen, she gets another kill. And the side out back to St. Michael with that 10-point lead. Going to the service line, Lexi Nelson. Knights up 18-8. And add an ace. Their third of this third set.
Again, with a healthy lead now again in set three. The Knights will just look to see if they can put it away.
Got a little English off the tape, but Coon Rapids able to recover. Callie Harris gets the kill.
Now, good positioning for Harrison. She did a nice job of the kill point on that. Going to get the set from Yang, and that's the point.
Laura Botch takes over at the service line. Looking for that back corner and misses.
Well, you certainly don't want to give a point away on your service like that. It's an unfortunate for the Cardinals, but an 11-point lead now for St. Michael Albertville.
And just 5 points away from a three-set sweep. That would send them to Blaine on Thursday for the quarterfinal matchup with the fourth-seeded Bengals. Oh. Wow, what a save. I was about to call it a kill for Callie Harris, but a great save by the Knights. Samantha Palmer gets the kill for St. Michael instead. A 21-9 lead. And look at that. I mean, she put her hand basically on the floor. That was Lexi Nelson laying out for it. The side out right back to Coon Rapids. Callie Harris at the service line. Howie? I feel another streak coming
out.
Right.
Let's see what happens.
Tanchin attacking, not completed. Gavick on the other side. Coon Rapids just passes it back over, trying to handle the power. And the little soft drop across the net by Samantha Palmer for the point.
Yeah, again, sometimes you don't need that power. If you get the little touch on it, like she did there, and gets the point, puts him 4 points away from finishing the night. 3 points.
Gavick with the kill. And they can feel it now, up 23-10 here in the third set.
Did a nice job setting it, and then Gavick with a kill shot.
Miller's serve misses the line, keeps Coon Rapids alive. Amy Slack will check in and head to the service line. Gavick again, this time blocked, able to keep it up. Pushed across by the Knights. Emma Wright attacking, Miller is there. Set goes to Palmer, she gets the kill, and it's going to be match point.
Well, Knights looking to put it away here. Grace Steffens.
Pass back across, here's the set. A big block. No, it went off the top of the net.
So Cardinals stay alive.
Four touches. A big streak.
Streak coming up right here.
Coon Rapids would need it, but the serve into the net, and that will be match point.
A quick exit for Coon Rapids here. They take to the road up in St. Michael Albertville. Quick three-set win for the Knights.
And a little bit of a disappointing finish for the Cardinals.
Yeah, but absolutely.
It was a rough year. They knew coming in they didn't have a lot of height. They didn't have a lot of experience. What they did have was a lot of youth and enthusiasm.
And heart.
And they hope. And they have bigger numbers, and that's something that they were really excited about at the beginning of the season. Numbers at the lower levels, that means the program is growing.
Right.
And they look to be stronger when they return next fall.
Yeah, with the youth in this program, they're looking to see if they can develop. Girls will continue to develop their game between now and next season, and they'll look to improve on this record.
Only football remains on the schedule for the CTN crew. We've got section playoffs. Number 8 Coon Rapids at number 1 ranked, top ranked team in the state, Totino Grace, on Friday. And then we will follow them should they come up with the unlikely upset over the Eagles.
We will.
But then after that, it's girls hockey. Coon Rapids taking on Wayzata, the Trojans, with their new head coach, former Cardinal coach and alumni, Jessica Christofferson. And we'll see that one on Saturday the 12th. Some more girls hockey on the 15th. Of course, the Coon Rapids Spring Lake Park team for girls hockey, the only team that we have to follow for those first couple of weeks. But we'll get heavily into the winter season after that. But that's going to do it for this edition of CTN Sports. Again, the final score from St. Michael, it's the Knights in 3, 25-6, 25-17, and 25-12. I want to thank everybody out there for joining us and continuing to support everything we do here at CTN for the entire crew, including Alex Shapiro. I'm Joe Young, saying good night.